Hello, my dear lovely student, class 6, subject math, chapter 2, whole numbers. So, our topic is properties of operations on whole numbers. Before this student, I want to explain what is operations in mathematics. You know that regarding the operations, how many types of operations? And we can see plus, minus, multiply and division. There are four operations. So with the help of four operation, we can solve so many questions. Now according to this one, some properties are given. What are the properties and what are used in our real life? So properties help us to solve the problem in our daily life. Similarly, we can say that identities or formulas also help to solve the problems and it becomes easier. So, first properties is closure property. So, here closure properties, the sum of any two whole numbers is a whole number. Examples, if A and B are two whole numbers, then additions of A and B will be A plus B. We can explain these examples by one diagram. Suppose you want to go to the school and your house is here and school is here. And this is the second diagram, your house is here and school is here. So, dear student, we can move in this way and we have to reach here destination is school, and here also we have to move in this way, and here we can reach the school. It means here are two ways, so we can write here the property, the sum of any two whole numbers. So if A and B are two whole numbers, then additions of A and B will be A plus B. As per example is given, 0 plus 1 is equal to 1, 5 plus 3 equal to 8. So here 1 and 8 are whole numbers. So commutative, second property is commutative properties of addition. So here A and B are two whole numbers. We can write A plus B equal to B plus A. Already I explained for this one examples on the basis of school. So we can write 2 plus 3 equal to 3 plus 2. 5 plus 7 is equal to 7 plus 5. I mean, suppose we have to add two whole numbers, we get a whole numbers and the effect, no effect on the result. Hence, we conclude that in whatever order we add two whole numbers, the sum of remains the same. Now, I am turning the page. Now, next is associative properties of addition. Here, we have to take three digits, three numbers. If A, B and C are whole numbers, then we can write A plus in the bracket B plus C is equal to A plus B in the bracket and plus C. Another example, suppose we have take 3 digits 2, 5 and 7 number. How we have to write, dear students? In this way we will be write 2 plus in the bracket 5 plus 7 is equal to 2 plus 5 in the bracket plus 7. If you'll be solve this and this, no effect on the result. So we group them in any way and add no effect on the result. I mean answer will be same. Fourth property is additive properties of zero. So here are also we can explain, suppose any number add to zero, you will be get the zero. Suppose apple plus zero is equal to apple, means same thing. If A is any whole number and we add to 0, it will remain unchanged. Examples, A plus 0 equal to A, 2 plus 0 equal to 2, 5 plus 0 equal to 5. So this is the result, this. Now I am going to giving the practice some question. First question is this one, second question in this one. On the basis of these properties, you have to think yourself also and try to write so many examples and you will be get the answer. I hope you have to understood my lecture. Thanks.